All right, we live. All right, we're out here once again on the highways and the byways, out here to prophesy the downfall of this wicked kingdom, which in the Bible is known spiritually as Sodom and Egypt, also Mystery Babylon, amongst other things. All right? First and foremost, we're going to give all praises, honor, and glory to our power, Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shai, Ba'ashem, Rakah Kodash. Double honors to the apostles of GMS who rule well and taught us this truth. Shalom to you, sincere Akiam, out there listening, learning, and pushing this truth. And our shalom to the few sincere Akwath out there listening and learning as well. All right? And I'm going to start out with saying, as usual, we're going to go into Rakah Kodash, right? Lord's will be edifying. I don't want to rot this off. But first and foremost, we opened up with the name Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, okay? And those names are very important. Yahweh is who the world ignorantly calls God, okay? God just means power, all right? His name is Yahweh, and his only begotten son's name is Yahweh Shai, all right? And they're so-called black men, so-called Negroes. Yahweh Shai, in particular, is a so-called Negro from the tribe of Judah. And they're coming back to destroy this place and redeem the elect of Israel, Yasharala. You so-called Negroes, West Indians, Haitians, Latinos, Hispanics, North American Seminole Indians, all right? You are the Lord's chosen people, all right? So with that being said, like I said earlier, Lord's will be edifying. Y'all brothers, bring out whatever y'all got.
So coming into these latter days, man, hey, the Lord is gonna start revealing these false prophets and these false doctrines, okay?
Hey, he's revealing them now.
Bit by bit, exposing people, man. And I was just watching a video the other day that a brother did, and it just had Kyrie Irving being interviewed by the media, and he was talking about, you know, he's not worried about the things that are happening in the game. He's worried about, you know, his people still being in captivity and things of that nature. The scripture says a little leaven spoileth the whole lump, okay? All right? And you're gonna see, you're gonna have a lot of people mixing different doctrines, a little bit of truth with a little bit of lies and so forth and so on, all right? So I'm gonna bring out this first scripture because at the end of the day, it's not these celebrities' jobs to bring out the truth, okay? The Lord could have easily gave the truth to a Jay-Z, a Will Smith, okay? And all their followers on Twitter and Instagram would just call themselves Israelites and be out in garments. The Lord could have easily did that, okay? But the Lord wants sincere Akiam and Akwa. Okay, he want men that believe on him and truly have faith. Okay? Exactly. This ain't the get along gang, man. Alright? This ain't a fad. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 9. And it reads, "For I think that Yahweh has set forth us, the apostles, last, as it were appointed to death. For we are made a spectacle unto the world and to angels and to men. We are fools for Hamashiach's sake." Okay? So I brought that out to say this, man. This is not gonna be a glamorous job. Okay? When Yahweh Shai came on the scene, who you people ignorantly call Jesus, he came humble, lowly on a donkey, man. All right? He came as low as possible. Okay? So that whoever could receive him will receive him. And 2/3 of our nation still turned their back on our Messiah, our Lord and Savior.
This is Matthew chapter 11, verse 4. Yahweh Shai answered and said unto them, "Go and show John again those things which ye do hear and see. The blind receive their sight, and the lame walk, and the lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear, and the dead are raised up, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. And blessed is he whomsoever shall not be offended in me."
Hey, you want to speak on it?
Yeah. So, simply put, man, Yahweh chose the meek and the lowly to preach this truth, man. And blessed are those who are not offended by this truth, man. There are many, many people who are offended for Yahweh Shai truth's sake, for John the Baptist's sake, and likewise for our sake, because we're continuing the work of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai.
Hey. And here's the thing, you know, this truth is sweet and then it's bitter, okay? But you have to have faith and believe in all the scriptures, man. The good, the sweet, and the bitter, okay? So, you know, sticking to the topic, you know, we're not out here to be all, you know, dressed in uniform you know, all made to look appealing. Okay? We're only made and commanded to come out here and speak the words of the Heavenly Father.
I got a quick precept. This is Romans chapter 16, verse 17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them.
Mm. And you're seeing a lot of that, man. You're seeing a lot of these false prophets, okay? Especially those of the circumcision. Throwing all type of different type of doctrines into this bowl of gumbo, making it a bowl of gumbo. Okay? And at the end of the day, the Lord, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, is gonna judge them for that. Okay? But this is why the Lord says, study to show thyself approved. All right? That's how you tell who's a false prophet. You study these scriptures so not one man can fool you, man.
Hey, the scripture said if it were possible, they would deceive the very elect.
Exactly.
Because you got to be careful of these men that come with the craftiness, man.
Yeah.
You know, these cunningly devised fables, man.
And you know when they come, they're smooth with the words, man.
Hey, could Jake love to hear smooth things?
Jake love to hear smooth things. Con.
Romans 16 and 17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned.
Hey, and if I can say this, this is why the apostles are great millstone. Hey, they watch every camp. And if anybody goes off, they're quick to correct. Okay?
The scriptures say rebuke, exhort with all long suffering, man.
Con. And a real man takes correction or what's the word I'm looking for? Takes getting a little chastised and say, you know what, Salakia, I was wrong, you're right, I was going off, I'm gonna correct it, and then move on. Okay? That's a sign of a true man of the Lord, a humble servant of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. Okay?
Got a precept.
It's a quick one?
Yeah, quick one. This is 2 John chapter 1, verse 10. If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed. For he that bideth him Godspeed is partaker of his evil deeds.
Con. All right? That's why the true men of the Lord, man, we've accepted the fact that our immediate family and friends that don't believe in this truth, okay, they're gonna get stiff-armed by us, okay? The Lord says we are not of the world, man. Okay, if we were of the world, the world would love our own. That's why we've become outcasts. We become outcast for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah's sake, man. You got it, Kariah.
You read that again, Baba Kasha?
Yeah, fool.
This is 2 John chapter 1, verse 10. If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house.
Hey, that's a cut to you damn unity camps, man. The scriptures say, can two walk together except they be agreed?
Kind.
That you brought out earlier, the get along gang, man.
Kind.
You gotta have the same sound doctrine, man. Like-minded individuals, man. Kind. He's teaching this sound doctrine. No leaven. All right? Like the brother said, a little bit of leaven the whole lump. Kind. Go ahead.
If there come any unto you.
Any of them. Don't give a damn who the hell it is, man.
Right.
I don't give a damn if you say you third in command under Yahweh Shai or not, man. If you ain't coming with no sound doctrine, I'm a stiff arm you, man.
Right.
Go ahead.
If there come any unto you and bring not this doctrine, receive him not into your house, neither bid him Godspeed.
Hey, that's the point, man. Ain't no shalom in him, ain't none of that, man.
None.
You know?
No praise, man. Godspeed is just basically being rejoicing when you see somebody, when you meet them. But nah, he say, hey, be cold-blooded, man.
Yeah, Con. Ain't no reason to rejoice when you see going off. Yeah.
Exactly.
He's leading the flock astray.
Con.
Well, I'm going to go back to that Romans. But real quick, Proverbs 29 and 1. He that being often reproved hardeneth his neck.
Ooh.
Hey, I brought up earlier, the Lord said, your neck is an iron sinew, man.
Iron sinew.
Hey, and like, I'm going to call names, man. I'm going to name names. the exalted grand poobah, Captain Kazaria.
Right.
That's why I wanted to open with the name of the Lord. That's a strong tower, man. That's the names of the Lord are highly important. Okay? You know?
And the Lord shows his name in a plethora of places throughout the scriptures.
Hey, but hey, you know what? Those names, Jehovah Wah, Yahweh Shai, that was given to us through faith, man.
Kind.
Which was a gift, and it wasn't given to everybody.
Kind.
You know? But hey, but like I said, and the elders always been getting on Captain Kazaria, man. Amongst other Nathaniel, you know, but they harden their neck and the scriptures say evil men shall wax worse and worse, man.
Worse and worse,
you know?
Man.
So Proverbs 29:1. He that be, and they become more proud. That's what happened.
Yeah.
They're so proud, so puffed up. Them titles, man.
That they can't take correction.
Con.
Yeah.
You
Who
know?
Are you to tell the third in command, the cat, you know what I mean? Exactly. Con.
So it says Proverbs 29:1. He that being often reproved hardeneth his neck shall suddenly be destroyed and without remedy. That's the point. Hey, you don't want to listen. Hey, the Lord gonna destroy you, man. All right? So going back to Romans 16:17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. For they that are such serve not our Lord Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, but their own belly.
Woo.
And by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple.
What
and, and the elders always go into that, man. Them people that follow Nathaniel, the IUIC, ISUPK, them walking zombies, man.
God.
They ain't got no goddamn car. Hey, they're insane in the membrane. Insane, got no brain. Because if you, hey, John the Baptist fell out the truth, them, the mark of the beast is not the RFID microchip. That's simple, that's easy to go search out and see. Oh, the mark of the beast is sleeping with white women. That's folly, that's nonsense.
Nonsensical, man.
You know, and they say these things because first and foremost, they under that gag order, that 501c3 charter.
Kind.
Okay? They're not coming out fully with the words of Yahweh Shemuel John. They teaching their own things, man. You know, what it is, they serving their own bellies.
Yeah, bring that last part back.
Again, Romans 16:17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions. Hey, and if you teach it contrary to what the elders taught, you bring a division. You scattering the sheep.
Especially when they learn the same sound doctrine.
They knew the name of the Lord.
They knew the name of the Lord.
You're going to say, nah, that's the title. Yeah, the Lord has many titles, but he has one name.
One name.
Many titles. Alashadja, terrible demon-like power. The Most High, that's a title. Okay? They like to say all praises to the Most High, like the APTMH.
Yeah.
That's a title, man. His name is Yahweh, and his son's name is Yahweh Shai.
Kind.
Okay?
You got it.
Anyway, Salakia. Romans 16:16-17. Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. For they are such, serve not our Lord Yahweh Shai HaMashiach, but their own bellies.
Their own bellies. They're doing it for the bag, man.
Man, hey, you got many different things. Not just the bag. That's one lust. But you got brothers that, hey, you see how we always talk about Florida, how all these camps are popping up all throughout Orlando.
Con.
Is major judgment gonna befall these camps, man?
Con.
You, the word is out here. You got the men of the Lord, okay? But you got men that are, you know, learn from the elders, see the men on the highways and the byways, but they don't wanna eat the whole roll. They wanna pick and choose what they wanna teach.
Con.
Like the Adam Abbott, them guys.
They don't wanna take the straight gate.
That's why what happened to him. He crept in unawares. He's coming another way. Because remember, Adam Abbott says, yeah, he's teaching you Israel, but he's not teaching the whole truth. He teaches that the mark of the beast is not the chip.
Con.
You see? He's serving his own belly. And you got, like you said, some people come in, maybe they come in for the bag, like you said. Some of them come in for camaraderie. They're not really coming in for the fear of the Lord. The scriptures say that knowing the terror of the Lord, we persuade men.
Con.
They're not moved by the fear. They move because they see the camaraderie, the brotherhood. Some of them, they want the women. You know, they got that effeminate woman demon on them. You be seeing them.
Yeah.
Kazaria, he got that woman demon on them. You know, they whatever they got. They